As I said, today's topic is flotation. So Sumo just moved away, then I can take the mask away. And the topic will be flotation with our TRNs. So most probably all of you know our TRNs already, but I would like to start with a short introduction, with a short repeat of the working principle of our submersible aerators TRN. So when we talk about the submersible aerators, the self-feeding system, we talk about a type of machine that is very similar to our submersible pumps. So you have a motor that leads to rotation of an impeller, and this impeller builds up a negative pressure in this yellow area that you see here directly below the mechanical seal. And due to this negative pressure, the air is sucked down self-feeding into the machine. It's mixed with the water that enters from below, and then this air-water mixture is discharged into all directions. So what we have is a mechanical aeration system. The only difference between a pump and the aerator is that we do not pump something out, we pump something in. So if we come to the concept of the submersed aeration, it is a very easy way of aerating tanks in municipal or in industrial applications where you need biology, where you need to add oxygen or bubbles into the medium. So you can see here, you have a freestanding installation. In that case, the unit is standing on the ground of the tank. It's just equipped to the air supply and the power supply. So silencer and valve are always part of the delivery of the system. You will have to attach an air tube that is usually the size that is defined by the machine, and you will have an electrical connection. And the working principle leads to the fact that you will have this convection scheme. You will have a main convection area where the bubbles rise after the depth aeration and lead to a direct oxidation of the water. And you will have a subconvection area, so a maximum tank area that can be covered, can be steered by the mixing convection of the machine. So what we are talking about is a combined system that can provide you an aeration of the medium plus a mixing function of your tank. So why does that make sense if we talk about flotation? So the concept of flotation is that you have a tank and you have a medium in there where substances are contained that nearly have the same density like water and will not rise to the surface of the tank without aerating this medium. So what we have these particles in there, we aerate the medium. In this case, it's an air supply that's from a pressurized system. At the same time, you agitate, and then the tiny bubbles will just simply rise in the tank. They will tack to the particles, bring the particles up to the surface of the medium. And then this froth is moved away. It is concentrated so that you can remove these particles that otherwise just simply will not rise. Why is our TRN an option for this flotation application? It is just simply because you can combine the main functions that are needed for an effective flotation in one machine. So you will have a self-feeding air supply. You don't need a pressurized system here. And at the same time, you will have an agitating function. So the TRN can offer you a trouble-free system to guarantee the agitation and the air supply of a flotation unit. What is the most relevant factor when it comes to flotation? I think it is quite clear. You can already see it on the left side on this big blue picture. It is the bubbles. So generally, the smaller, finer the generated air bubbles, the better is the separation and the flotation effect in the medium. This means the tinier the bubbles, the tinier the particles that can be separated from the medium. The higher the total number of bubbles that you have in the medium, and the better the separation effect. So as our TRNs are usually designed for activation purposes in municipal and industrial wastewater treatment plants, we are not talking about a microbubble system in our case. So this means that we have to modifications on the TRNs to make them suitable to reduce the bubble size of the unit as much as possible. Because just remember you on the general topic here, the smaller, finer the bubbles, the more effective the system. So we had some problems with competitors in the past that were just doing advertisements with very tiny bubbles. And it was true, our bubbles were generally bigger than the micro bubble systems, but we found a way to modificate our TRNs to make them suitable and to reduce the bubble sizes. I will just show you a video now where we summarized the hydraulic effects. Let's check that. So there we go.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, from the technical department of Tsurumi.
I hope that all of you can hear us.
Of a modification of one of our submersible aerators, TRN.
Trying to find
we are having to face the problem that in the application of flotation, we need very tiny gas bubbles. To decrease the sizes of our gas bubbles, we have the possibility to close the air valve of our self-feeding system. The problem that we are facing in this situation is an amperage increase. To compensate this amperage increase, we would like to modify the unit by installing the impeller and the suction plate, means the hydraulic of the 60 Hz version, to lower the amperage at the same time and to compensate the amperage increases.
I do not know if you can hear me parallelly to the video, but something that you can see immediately here is that we were able to decrease the bubble size, and we did a lot of testing, and it came out that with the 80% closed air valve, we are still in the area of acceptable amperage draws, and the bubble size decreases relevantly.
So, technical modification on the submersible aerator TRN to make it suitable to compensate the amperage losses that we have from closing the air valve. What we're doing right now, we're changing the 50 Hz hydraulics, means the suction plate and the impeller, to the version of 60 Hz. So in the best case, this would compensate the amperage losses that we have from closing the air valve and make it possible to operate it on a running amperage again.
This is the effect of the modifications. With 80% closed air valve, you can see that you have less trouble less moving of the medium at much smaller bubbles. Still, the amperage will be absolutely acceptable. The unit will not burn. And this is due to the changed hydraulics, due to the smaller size of the impeller. Here you can see the direct comparison. In the background, you can see that the bubbles are also rising slower and have more time for the flotation effect in the medium due to the reduced size. So that's it. Let's talk about some potential applications that we are talking about. So just to summarize again, the kind of modification that we have done. So the problem was that if you close the air valve nearly fully, then the amperage draw of the machine will increase. To reduce that and to be able to close the air valve nearly fully, we just changed the hydraulics of the machine to 60 Hertz, means changing the suction plate and the impeller. So we had an amperage loss, so a smaller amperage draw of the machine. And at the same time, we increased the amperage draw of the machine again by closing the air valve. That is the only thing that we have done. In the end, the outcome was that we could create much smaller, finer bubbles to increase the separation effect, the flotation effect. Let's talk about applications. The typical flotation application is in municipal industrial wastewater stations. You find aerated sand traps. This is the second step of the physical wastewater treatment, where you have a combination of the removal of sand and a fat and grease removal. So you can see a drawing on the right side where we have three aerators in line. They are just installed on the anchored ground of the tank, and they will just simply aerate the medium. They will skim off the substances, the fat and grease from the medium that is removed from the top. And at the same time, due to sedimentation effects, the sand will fall to the ground and is removed from the deepest position of the tank. So this is a combination that you will find very often in municipal and industrial wastewater treatment stations if you have to get rid of fat and grease and at the same time of sand. Another one with the same principle is flotation cells that you find in municipality and in industry. So those are standardized cells for removing fat and grease and small fibers. It's again in the physical step of the wastewater separation. Here you can see some photo that you will recognize a little bit later on if I give you an example. So the aerator in this case is hanging in the tank. It's just aerating the medium. Then you have an overflow on the tap where the foam is removed. And at the same time, the sand is sinking to the ground and can be removed from the ground of the tank. Another successful application that we were carrying out in the past is paper recycling. So the principle is that you mix the paper rests with water and you create some sort of a slurry. And then you have to separate the paper fibers from the medium to being able to recycle them again. So the unique selling points of our submersible aerators TRN in those kind of applications is that those units cannot get blocked. If you work with the pressurized system in paper recycling flotation facilities, then the pores of the membranes will clog very fast. Our units will not clog that fast. And so the paper recycling could be a potential application for the installation of the TRNs as well. I talked about an example that I would like to use. That was an example that we were very lucky to be able to carry out because it could give us a direct comparison with a competition unit in the market. So we are talking about the wastewater treatment station of Hallau in Switzerland. It's a 21,000 population equivalent station that was refurbished in 2014. And in this particular case, you have two parallel flotation cells called 1 and 2 on the picture here. And in cell 1, we had the chance to replace one of the competitor unit by one of our 50 TRN 42.2 kilowatt flotation unit, and just have a direct comparison between a competitor product in the one cell with 3 kilowatt and our unit with 2.2 kilowatt in the other cell. After 1 year, we came back to this installation and we checked results, because the operator of the wastewater treatment station was comparing and was just triggering results of the operation. And the effect was that separation effect in cell 1 and cell 2 was completely identical. For us, that does not sound that tremendous, but if you just do a cost comparison, then we are talking about 0.8 kilowatt per hour cost saving in direct comparison between the machines of 2.2 kilowatt Tsurumi and the 3.0 kilowatt competitor machine. If you calculate that for 24 hours running time, 365 days operation per year, then we talk about a cost or energy saving of 7,008 kilowatt per year. And if we calculate that with 19 Rappen, which is the industrial energy costs in Switzerland at that time, then we are talking about the yearly cost saving of 1,331.52 Swiss francs. So that is quite an investment that you're doing, but you're saving the cost for the machine very soon, so it will pay off very fast. At the same time, we had some effects that the clogging resistor of our system was much higher due to the construction of the system itself. So we have the air supply from the top and the water supply from the bottom. The comparison unit was the other way around, so that you had a mechanical seal in direct contact with the medium. So the technical reliability of our system can be judged as much higher than the other one. So let's go back to the naming of the TRNs. This is the naming that all of you know from your price list, from the catalogs, from the internet, from some trainings that we had in the past. So if we talk about the normal TRN units, you will already find all the relevant information on the machine in the title of the machine. So 32 in that case stands for the air inlet bore in diameter and millimeter. So this is also the recommended size that the air tube should have. Then we're talking about TRN, this is the new aerator series. We talk about 2 or 4, this is the poles of the motor. In that case, it's a two-pole motor. Then we have the motor output as most relevant figure. It's P2, 1.5 kilowatt in that case. And then we have 52 or 62, gives you an information about the hertz frequency of the machine. 2 in that case, it's the version number, but you are quite familiar with that. So something that is new is that. So the particular built flotation machines that we will offer in the market will have an addition. It will be after the kilowatt size of the motor, you will have an addition that is called FL for flotation version. Why do we do that? Why we give this your baby a new title? The simple fact is that if you want to replace hydraulics on an FL unit, this will not be identical to the normal TRN units, because we are talking about 60 Hertz hydraulics here. If you have an FL version, you're always sure that you have a smaller impeller, you have a different suction plate. So you need to find this information about the changed hydraulics in the title of the machine. Otherwise, you will order the wrong spare parts. So this is the reason why we added the FL in the title of the machine. Let's go to the model range of the two TRNs. The normal TRNs in 50 Hertz that are used for wastewater treatment, we have 10 different machines between 0.75 and 40 kilowatt, and surely the bigger ones will not be interesting for flotation potations. So we did a survey in the market. We asked all our distributors that are quite active in this sector for their preferences regarding the motor sizes. We also checked the competition and the motor sizes that they are offering. And we just came to the fact that it is necessary to have the 4 smaller units. So namely the 750 watts, the 1.5, 2.2 and 3.7 kilowatt machines as flotation units. So those will be the units that will be available with the addition FL in a standard build for flotation applications. So we all know that traditionally short-term availability is a key factor for our success in Europe. So we would like to have this key factor, this key advantage also for the flotation units. So due to this fact, we decided in discussion with our distributors and with our subsidiaries European wide that we need to build up a stock in Antwerp that will make the units immediately available. And we are happy to inform you that from the mid of 2021, we have agreed on the initial stock and we will have the following numbers of units available from the mid of 2021 for your direct sales. So it's 8 units of the 750 watts. It will be 15 units of the 1.5 kilowatt and 2 units of the bigger ones. So this is to be understood as an initial stock. We will just check the necessity of the market, and there's surely room for adjustment. If you have bigger projects, if you need bigger numbers, let us know in advance, and then we will be able to just simply build up a stock that is much more to your liking or to your needs. But this is the initial situation that we will be talking about from the mid of 2021. We will have a direct availability of these 4 units that offer all the factors that I discussed in this introduction video. So in the end, that's it. I'm not quite sure if we had questions because Susumu was dealing with the questions in between. He just tells me that there were no questions. Then we thank all of you for your patience and for the time that you invested in us.